Hello everyone. Thank you for joining this webinar on the dawn of the recovery story. So if we look at the past, a lot has changed since the month of March 2020. We are no longer looking at the same volatile levels in the market. We are no longer looking at the same pessimism in the market. Coming to now, a lot has changed in terms of the production volumes, in terms of other indicators and the health of the economy at a large level. Talking about the future outlook, what we'll do in today's webinar is delve deep into yesterday and today's data to predict the outlook for tomorrow. And to help us with all of this, I have Jaspreet Singh Arora, Chief Investment Officer at Research and Ranking. He needs no introduction now. You name any roles in the finance domain, be it corporate finance, equity research, financial analysis, business strategy. He has played an integral role with leading organizations such as Anand Rathi, Angel Broking, Systematic Shares and Security. So over to you, Jaspreet, now.
Thanks. Thanks, Jigna. And a very good evening to everyone. Saturday evening, got to say, we can't keep it boring. We'll keep it as entertaining and light as possible. Let me say today's theme is Bollywood. India understands a couple of religions. Bollywood's right up there. Cricket, it's next. And many more. So I promise next time we'll do it. We'll base it around IPL. Today, possibly we are opening that. We have that open match today. But our today's theme is Bollywood. Let's see what we're going to discuss. Trying to correlate, right? The Indian economy, what are the lessons based on our theme of Kal Aaj Aur Kal? What's the investment lessons from the past? What are the opportunities in the present market? The market outlook for the coming times, and the way we want to portray it in our Bollywood way, wealth creation anthem, which Jigna just mentioned. This will be you will hear it almost live after 25 minutes. So we'll keep it short, crisp, entertaining, very, very interactive for the next 25 minutes. Thereafter, we'll have that quick anthem stroke song, and then we open for Q&A. So all in all, we're requesting is a sharp 50, 55 minutes of your next span. And I promise it will be worth it. Okay, the basics first. What happened? What happened at the start of the year? What happened during mid-year? And what's the current situation? Let's analyze that first, right? To put the bricks or the foundation right at the start. The markets, as we look at it, is driven by three factors. It's at various stages of time. So what, number one is earnings, number two is sentiments, and then three is liquidity. So between Jan and some part of Feb, it was like mid-Feb, right? It was largely earnings, as was the whole of last calendar year, right? That earnings were the dominant factor behind stock prices moving up or down or being static. Followed by, sentiments took over when you had, COVID impacting nations like China first and from the developed economies, then US, and finally it hit India. And that took a big toll, and the market tanked like more than 40% between Feb 12th to 23rd March, exact dates, Feb 11th till 23rd March, market tanked more than 40%. And who would forget 23rd March? The 7,500 Nifty when everybody was shivering and shaking and in the stock market participants if you want to look at that way. What happened thereafter was unbelievable, right? The 7,500 Nifty and the stocks and mid caps and large caps, they're almost back where they are. In many cases they're even higher from where they started. So liquidity, sentiments, everything put together drove that bounce back, which was a sharp. And obviously the last 1 or 2 months is also the earnings, which is kind of aiding to it. When I'm saying earnings, we look ahead. What I mean by that, what I mean is the 1Q has been very, very strong. Okay, just to take an example of what happened in 2008, the last big crash, right, in which was the Lehman crisis, and I was right up there in that phase of panic. that crash actually lasted almost 12 months. 6,000 index went down to 2,900, right? It lasted 12 months, right? This time around, it lasted 2 months, as I said, early Feb to mid-March, 23rd March to be specific. Then in 2008, the pullback happened. The pullback took 22 months, right? This time around, the pullback has happened in 4 months, right? And we are just saying pullback from the Nifty, keeping Nifty as a benchmark, and the, from the place where it dipped and the place where it's moved back to its original position. In 2008, the consolidation phase lasted 28 months, and thereafter, start of 2013 calendar, what we saw was a mega bull run, which took the index up almost 35-40%, right? 6,000 index going as up to 8,300, right? So, we believe that the current phase that we are in is broadly the same, where the next 3-5 months we will be in that broad consolidation zone, right? And once that phase is over, where what I mean is, let's say the big events like the US elections, the proven vaccine is available, it's available even on the Indian territory, right? And we're getting the assurances from the government that we need not panic anymore, and it's the one is kind of moving out as fearlessly, or let's say 90% as fearlessly as we were doing it till Jan, then obviously we are almost closer to November, or let's say end of December. Our sense is what will follow thereafter is the pace, is the phase which we saw in 2013 to 15, as I mentioned, where we should slowly and steadily start moving up, driven by earnings and stock specific. Okay, let me just give you a synopsis of while I'm trying to juxtapose the current year behavior with 2013. Let me tell you what happened while the consolidation phase was on, and the period after that, right? So even while the consolidation phase was on in October 10 to Feb 13, there were 25 stocks which gave more than 100% return, right? And there were 60 stocks which gave over 50% return. And you can look at it from the basket that we have put across to you. It was from consumption, it was from BFSI, it was from pharma, it was from auto, right? It was large caps, TCS, in HCL Tech. It was as from that space, like a Bajaj Finserv, Bajaj Finance, ITC, Marico, Asian, Titan, Godrej, or they were mid caps, or they were even small caps, right? There were still 60 stocks, even when the consolidation phase was on, that gave good returns. Let's look at the next phase, 2013 to 2015, when the big bull run happened. There were 160 stocks that gave 100% return. There were 240 stocks that gave 50% return. Enormous basket to choose from, right? And believe me, we need not have 50, 60, 100 stocks. All we are interested in is a couple of 15, 20, 25 stocks to be chosen from that basket, which we believe can give that 50, 100% return, has the potential to give 50, 100% return in the near future. Again, those were across baskets, consumption, pharma, BFSI, miscellaneous, auto, and they were all over. Okay, let's come to current year, right? What's just to understand, April and May, the forecast on the Nifty was that it'll go down, the Nifty EPS will go down over 20%, and the GDP growth will be in excess of 10%, right? 10%, 15%, closer to that number. Now, right, what's happening is that the Nifty EPS is getting very, very clear that we will be in a zone where which is -5% to -10%, while the EPS decline may not be more than 5%. That's the situation today. Let's take it forward. As I said, we'll be having Bollywood as a theme to understand, right? What's the objective is to understand. And put it in a layman's term, right? So there was this movie in 1971. It was released more before I was born, but I happened to be watch it, and it was very interesting movie, right? And it was Randeep's debut movie, and he was incidentally the director as well. So the message there was that there were three generations of a family trying living together, and there were conflicts that kept on happening between the three generations, right? And that happened almost the entire movie. However, at the end, they realize that, you know, there's no point trying to fight over small things. At the end of the day, we have to live in the same house, and we got to respect each other, right? I mean, obviously, the grandfather, you know, kind of agreeing to most of the grandson's requests and practical expectations. In the current situation, you know, what we are saying is there will be three sets of data. There will be data. Everything and anything that you will get bombarded every day will be data. But how do you, you got to give respect to all the three data. One, which is related to Kal, which was yesterday, whether it is related to Aaj, which is today, or it is related to Kal, which is the coming day, right? Or which is tomorrow, right? So, wo data kisse related hai? Wo pichle beeta hua kal se hai, aaj se hai, which is the today, ya aane wale kal se hai, right? The moment we have an answer for that, or the moment we get that positioning right, we will have our you know, stocks or the way how to invest. There will be far more clarity than what we have today, right? Let's look at it in detail. So this is, let's say, the beeta hua kal, which is where the domain of, you know, the big daddy, Mr. Prithviraj Kapoor, the domain of the Kapoor family. It, let's say, pertains to that, right? Okay, this is data which got published on the 31st August, all right? But it is related to beeta hua kal. All right, GDP data was -24% in India, the lowest in the last, I don't know how many decades, right? But it is beeta hua kal. Uski wajah se, what will happen is the current year GDP growth rate will be negative. Negative 4%, negative 5%. But that's it, right? It's already been factored in. Also, the many advanced economies will see a decline, right? Advanced economies, developed economies, developing economies, including India. At the same time, there will be a bounce back next year. There will be a bounce back next year. Every time a dip happens, 2008, there a dip happened in the GDP rate. 2009, there was a sharp bounce back. All right. Again, beeta hua kal, same GDP growth rate. If you compare that -26%, the bar at the extreme right, and compare it with any other economy on the left hand side, whether be it Germany or Spain or Mexico or France, Korea, US, Japan, Australia. We look to be much worse off. But why is that? We need to understand that. It is because of the most stringent lockdown that we had implemented, which was you know, the most strictest globally, right? But the positive, the, or the rub off of that was also that the fatality rate is far, far lesser. We got the time to put our infrastructure, health infrastructure, and everything in order during that time. Also, the second lesson to be derived from here is, look at China's number. China's number in this quarter was +12%. And what was it in the previous quarter? It was -10%, right? If we just take this as an example, where China, which was impacted more heavily in the March quarter, right? It got impacted to the extent of 10% contraction in GDP. Unka GDP is quarter May, the last quarter, April, May, June, went up 12%, right? So if India's GDP has gone down -26%, I'm sure it will bounce back equally sharply in the following quarter. I'm not saying it's going to be a positive, but it's not. And believe me, it's not going to be in double digit, high double digit negative. I can tell you that for sure. Okay. 1Q results bahut achhe aaye hain abhi tak. Nifty ka earnings decline has been about 26%, right? Almost same as the sales decline. The healthcare and technology sector ne bahut acha kiya hai, FMCG chemicals ne bahut acha kiya hai, the Bharat, right, the rural India has done much better than urban India, and also the fact that EBITDA and PAT have fallen much lower than sales is a testimony ki corporate India ne they have cut down on fixed cost very well. Okay, this is what the EPS growth has been, right, across sectors. I will not bore you with too much data here. The larger idea here is that pharma, telecom, utility, banks have done well. The what has not done well is retail infra metals paints. However, they are obviously the candidates where bounce back zyada hoga, isliye opportunity bhi wahan zyada milegi. Also, in terms of when you look at below expectations, in line and above expectations for the first quarter, you see there are more companies on the right hand most quadrant, which is above expectations, and equal companies in the in line, while the lower than expectations is far lower. And we are looking at let's say the top 100, top 150 companies, and trying to highlight this is broadly the trend, right? That it was not as dark, as gloomy, utna kharab nahi tha jitna hum log soch rahe the April mein, May mein, even in early June, right? Obviously peeche se bahut corporate ne kafi mehnat ki hai, therefore this is the result of that the earnings decline utna nahi hoga. Usi beete hue kal mein kya hua hai, 3.5 lakh crore ka फंड रेजिंग हुआ है, राइट? कैसे हुआ है? आईपीओ से हुआ है, राइट? रोजारी बायोटेक सबको याद होगा, रिसेंटली लिस्टेड केमिकल कंपनी, बहुत अच्छा गया है. आईपीओ प्राइस 425, करंट प्राइस 825. हमने भी हमारे प्रोडक्ट एमपीओ है उसमें हमने रिकमेंड किया था ये स्टॉक. एफपीओ यस बैंक ने एफपीओ में फॉलो ऑन पब्लिक ऑफर में 13,000 करोड़. रिलायंस जियो कैन फॉरगेट दैट बिग बैंग फंड रेज एट द डे 1,52,000 करोड़. And this is, believe me, that was the biggest fundraise in a particular month globally, right? What Reliance Jio did. QIPs mein aur 62,000 crore ka fundraise hua hai, OFS mein 12,000 crore, secondary sale mein kul milake 3.5 lakh crore we have raised, and believe me, it's no small amount. This is the highest amount of fundraise that has happened in public market in that phase of April, May, June, July, August, right? It shows that there is an appetite for quality paper and people are willing to bet on it. That's a larger message. Okay, this is very interesting, right? You can connect with it. What I'm trying to highlight here is ki, you know, Corporate India had did its own bit of innovation, right? Be it putting out electric sanitizing machine, which Orient launched, jisme aapne fruits dal diye, mobile dal diya, keychain dal diya, right? And it all gets sanitized all in one shot. They were a bread launched by Modern Bread. Mass was obviously everybody's favorite. Maruti had that partition driven option given. Amul launched many flavors. The famous amongst them was Tulsi Doodh and Ginger. I didn't taste Chyawanprash ice cream, but I'm sure many of you who would have tasted would have loved that option, given if not, that was not the option earlier. This is broadly the, you know, the message here is that there was innovation everywhere. Corporate India was not sitting idle. They were trying to give whatever best possible, which is required by general public, so that you know, consumption is there and they feel secure to consume that. Dabur, I mean, one of our portfolio companies, they're just moving it to the next level. They launched a flurry of products, and believe me, as we talk, pichle mahine unhone 3 mahine 3 products naye launch kiye hain, or in the next 3 months they will launch another 4-5 new products. They are right up there in terms of innovation. These are some of the products on Tulsi and other haldi and amla base that they have for the offering. Asian Paints had their bit of a contribution by you know, ensuring that everybody's house was getting painted in a very, very safe and friendly manner. So just the idea is to show that, you know, there was innovation everywhere and people wanted to feel safe and sound while consuming these things. Okay, now what is there? It is the Raj Kapoor's times, which is aaj, right? Let's say aaj is the Raj Kapoor's time, right? Which is what is happening in July and August and September. I'm saying this is the running quarter, right? That's a larger objective. What has happened in the running quarter? Look at the automobile sales, and believe me, automobile sales is a very, very good indicator of what the economy is doing, where is it heading, right? And what is our underlying strength? Two-wheeler sales are 80 to 90% of what they were pre-COVID. At least 100 bikes bikti thi, abhi 80, 85, 90 bikes bikti hain. Four wheelers are 90 to 100%. 100 gaadiyan bikti thi pehle matlab Jan and Feb run rate, right? Aaj 90-100 bik rahi hai. In fact, in Maruti's case, they even did a volume growth of 14% plus. Organized jewelry is seeing 60-70% attraction. Pehle 70 units bikte the, 100 units bikte the, aap 70 units bik rahe hain. This I'm saying there is a run rate for July, August, and September, and so on and so forth for paints, consumer durables, steel. You look at any, and believe me, all these numbers are based on a channel checks. And when we did the similar channel check in May and June, it was 40-50%. In July, it was 60%. And today we are heading to 80% plus across categories. Very, 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 very encouraging data to notice. ई वे बिल्स इज नथिंग बट जो हाईवे पे गाड़ियां चलती हैं उनका फैक्ट्री से जब गाड़ी निकलती है तो ई वे बिल फटता है एंड दैट इज व्हाट दे नीड टू शो एट ऑल द चेक पोस्ट बिफोर रीच द अल्टीमेट डेस्टिनेशन दैट्स अ वेरी गुड बैरोमीटर ऑफ ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड यू नो हाउ स्ट्रॉन्ग द इकोनॉमी इज नाउ इट इज 97% बैक 100 ई वे बिल्स पहले जनरेट होते थे तो आज 97 जनरेट हो रहे हैं रेल फ्रेट इज बैक पैसेंजर व्हीकल्स वी डिस्कस्ड यू नो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इज बैक as we discussed, just wanted to highlight Hero MotoCorp, some of the names, Maruti 17% growth. Again, this is growth for the month of August compared to same period last year, August 19, right? There are greens which are emerging now. There are growth areas which are emerging now, right? Which is only the case with tractors earlier till May, June, July. In August, even two-wheelers, even four-wheelers are now participating by showing growth. What has also happened in August, which is aaj ka time, which is, you know, there were border tensions, the GST collections were tipped, they were down about 85,000 crore. But let's say if we were at a 95,000 crore plus steady state earlier, we are very close to, you know, 90% of normalcy. The bond yields and also the interest rates currently are at multi-year low. 15 saal pehle agar aap HDFC ke paas jate ya kisi home loan लेने की कोशिश करते हैं जो आपको रेट मिलता आज आपको वो रेट मिल रहा है उससे भी कम मिल रहा है 7% रॉक बॉटम इंटरेस्ट रेट्स एंड लो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स लो क्रूड प्राइसेस राइट लो इन्फ्लेशन एवरीथिंग इज पॉजिटिव फॉर द इक्विटी मार्केट दैट्स व्हाई वी आर हाईलाइटिंग दिस ओके लेट्स सी द कल व्हिच इज व्हाट रणधीर कपूर इज व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू हाईलाइट दिस इज द समरी ऑफ दैट कल राइट here I'm trying to break it into three quadrants, right? The leftmost quadrant is what the Jan and Feb was. You look at the red, green, blue, and yellow. Red is obviously it's a danger zone. It's not a happy number. Yellow is obviously more of a watch. Blue is neutral, and green is a very good healthy number. So you look at the mid quadrant, the period between March and July, there are maximum reds, right? And followed by yellows, right? They're very few blues and green, you can hardly see anything. Green, aapko ekka dukka ye niche, you know, July ke end mein aapko do jagah dikh jayega, urban employment, rural employment mein. Now, based on data coming, again, this is not hawa mein nahi dala gaya, this is based on data. I don't have the data right now. But there's very selective data, but you know, you get auto data, just say August ka aa gaya, so basis that I have put the color coding for the August and September. And obviously there onwards, you're expecting an improvement. So aage ka quadrant dekhiye, August to December, far more greens, right? Far more blues, right? And far more yellows. And the red is hardly anything except like a air traffic, which obviously hum sabko pata hai ki thoda time lagayega, 4-6 mahine lag jayenge usko. Before it comes back to normal, before you and me feel absolutely secure and safe to take a flight, जो हम बेझिझक पहले लेते थे, वो और तो सब एक्सटेंड सीवी थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम में रहेगा. Rest everything. Look at the quadrant August to December 20, and believe me, ये अगर ऐसा है इसका, you know the green the colors mix right, which is more of green, more of blue, and followed by yellow. You can imagine the months following that will be even more better, which will have, you know, even a better picture. So what's the short and medium term outlook? The outlook is let's see in terms of what are the events. So there is a vertical unlock which is still pending in a couple of areas like entertainment zones, restaurants, bars, multiplex, gym, clubs, and obviously you have state level, district level, vertical lockdowns. These are the two events with. Our sense is next month much of this would get lifted and obviously, you know, depending on city to city and state to state, this will get eased out and you will see far more consumption in those zones as well. US elections is just an event. Our sense is 2016 mein bhi hua tha, ek do mahine mein settle down ho gaya. Beyond that, not much importance to be given. And in India we have a state elections in Bihar. Not much importance, but except that hoga nahi hoga, it might get postponed, and also how the way they will wanna conduct it. That's an important event. Just for the sake of highlighting it. Okay, let's look at numbers. So based on the earnings of current year, right, which we said will fall by 5 to 10%. So we are taking 8% is our bottoms approach says 8% is where Nifty earnings will go down. However, it will go up by equally sharply 35% next year, right? And based on that long-term average of 18 to 22 times, our senses on the on Nifty, the fair price comes to anywhere between 11,000 to 13,500, right? So any price which is 3-4% lower than the current Nifty becomes a very, very good attractive point. So 11,000 Nifty becomes a very, very attractive zone. Just in case anybody is interested in looking at what is that zone, there onwards. However, we don't subscribe to this, and we'll come to that in a bit. Okay, there's a famous quotation from Mr. Peter Lynch, over 75 years age, over 50 years of experience. What he says is, far more money has been lost by investors preparing, you know, for corrections or trying to anticipate corrections than has been lost in corrections themselves. Yeah, correction mein dhoondne mein itna time aur wo waste kar dete hain. The opportunity loss is so big, usse bada, you know, that is a much bigger loss than the loss in actual corrections themselves. And we have already seen that, right? So our friends or our clients, you know, who are waiting for that perfect correction opportunity, our advice to them has been and will continue to be, let's not wait for that perfect opportunity. It will just probably come and go. Have your strategy set. What is that strategy that we are getting? We'll just come that in a bit. Hero Motocorp has been just to highlight an example, because sir, ye sab to theek hai sir, ye to gyan bahut ho gaya. Stock kaun sa lena hai, kaun sa bechna hai, aapne kaun sa stock client ko dilaya aur wo chala hai ki nahi chala, right? That is where just trying to highlight a good franchisee, Hero Motocorp, under a mispriced opportunity. We had highlighted, right, in April at 1800, went up to 2,500 where we exited, and it's closer to 3,000 rupees now. And anything and everything that you would get from our desk will be research backed, right? There will be the parameters, the investment arguments, and numbers, right? Nothing will come without this. So it had a strong rural presence, entry-level bikes mein unka bahut acha presence hai, input costs niche gayi, wo bahut acha unke liye benefit raha, steel and metal prices and a little bit of plastics. Balance sheet bahut strong hai unki, cash equivalents 5 crore ke upar hai, 10% of stock price, and valuations was like 15 year low, 11 times P mein mil raha tha. Deepak Nitrite has been a multi-bagger for us, been a 3x plus, 3.5x almost. We recommended at 250 bucks about 2 years back, roughly about 20 months back to be exact, and we've been riding on that chemical story, and we still continue to back this opportunity. Indian chemical players ke liye bahut badi hai, aur year after year hai, ek do saal char panch saal ki nahi hai, year after year hai, right? This company is very good in what it does, which is, you know, phenol and acetone. Our downstream derivatives portfolio bahut strong hai, bahut hi diversified hai, technically very, very strong. It used to be a 4,000 crore small cap company when we started advising it to our clients. Today it's almost 12,000 crore, right? A 3x ever since, and we believe it has more legs to grow. That's been in terms of stocks, just, you know, one stock each from our two products, trying to give a flavor of our strategy. And what's our strategy? We, you know, typically have about 20 to 22 stocks in our clients' portfolio. We would have we will have about 60% or less in large caps, 40% or more in mid. Obviously, here includes the small caps as well, which has been what's been moving up in the last 1 week more than ever. And we will obviously, you know, in some of our aggressive portfolios, we have, in fact, you know, mid and small caps is 50% and large is 50%. So we have that equal mix depending on the client risk profile. How do we select stocks? We have an ABC analysis. What it says is A is all weather, which means the paints, the FMCG, the IT, right? Pichle 10 saal mein, 5 saal, 10 saal, 15 saal, earnings growth double digit rahi hai. And stock price compounding also has been double digit. Therefore, we have this conviction ki 10-15-20% compounding year after year rehni chahiye, and that is comes under all weather. Business momentum is like, let's say, space like a pharma or a chemical, right? Or a mid-cap IT or a digital, stuff like that, which is where we think ki 20-30% compounding return minimum possible for the next couple of years. And third is obviously the circle of opportunity, something like telecom may agar kuch opportunity hai or you know there is a loss, a company which is in losses and will turn out to be in big profits, wo hum usme thoda allocate karte hain. All in all, our idea is to have a basket where earnings is 20%. Believe me, earnings agar 20% ki compounding mil jayegi, balance 5, 7, 10% agar re-rating se hai, 25-30% overall compounding definitely possible. If you have this a broad mix across sectors, across momentum, and also, as I said, across mid and small caps. In terms of broad sector allocation, the largest you can see is in consumer discretionary and auto. We have about 25% allocated there. Staples is about 15%, which is same as BFSI. We will increase BFSI obviously as and when we get confidence. For now, it's underweight, 15%. Chemical, pharma, and agrochemical, we believe will have a long rope to grow, and that is what we have allocated 20%. Economy facing is 12%, and IT, media, telecom is 8%. And believe me, this is not fixed, plus minus 5%, upar niche hota rehta hai. And we will keep on doing it. But the larger, the broad view as of now is this, just to give you a glimpse of what it's like. So what's our wealth creation anthem? That will be better. Aapko sunne mein bahut zyada maza aayega. But let me just illustrate before we get to that listening part. Which is where we say there are, couple of S you need to focus on. The first S is the staggered buying approach. Please stagger your investments. The way we look at it, we typically advise clients to at least put 50% now, right? The day they want to get into the market, and the balance 50% can be divided over 3 months, can be divided over 5 months, can be divided over 2 months, depending on the view on that stocks or view in the market or what we are advising at that point of time. But minimum 50% is what we ask the clients to put. Within that, it's again stock specific. It's not ki sare stocks mein aapne 50% dal dena, right? It has to be stock specific. Let's say we identify 25 stocks, we advise, and we think these 15 are good to go in the first day itself. That is where we will tell you to put that 50%. This is how we look at it. Hame hamare 25 stocks se matlab hai, not Nifty 500, right? Not those BSE 5000 stocks. Our idea is to pick those 25 stocks who we think will give those compounding. A long-term approach without saying, no 6 months, 1 year, view when coming to equity market, unless there's a product which is meant for that only. Stay focused, stay away from all those distraction, and trust that, just don't try and time the market. Ki aaj main bech deta hun, 11,500 Nifty hai, kal ko 10,000 ka view hai, to I will pull back. It doesn't happen. 10,000 aayega, aap 10,000 pe aap. I'm not saying 10,000 nahi aayega, right? Nahi aa sakta. I don't think it will come, but aisa nahi ki nahi aa sakta. But aayega to fir aap 9,000 ki wait karenge. And we have seen it. All of us have seen it. You would have seen it in March, right? And I've seen it in 2008. I've seen it in 2002. The 2001, the 9/11 crash. So it just doesn't work trying to time the market. Yeah, that's it. I guess that's where I stop. We'll take the questions of our audience now, and handing over to Jigna.
So Jaspreet, we have been getting a lot of questions. One such question is, when to exit from the market or from any specific stock? Should it be okay? So if I'm aiming at 50% returns and I've got my return, then should I exit from that particular stock, or are there any combination of other factors that one should consider while exiting a stock?
So this is not there's not an easy or a right or wrong answer for this, but the way we approach this is that, first to identify whether you bought this stock for a 3 year or a 1 year or a 5 years, right? If we had bought Deepak, just take an example, Deepak Nitrite Chemicals company in our client's portfolio, and our 1 year targets have been breached, but we are still holding on, right? And it's been kind of been proven right, because had we sold earlier, we would not have got those last 30% return, because the clear mandate here is, the clear idea here is that hum isko एक नहीं, दो तीन चार पांच साल के व्यू के हिसाब से हम हमने इसको यू नो वी हैव टेकन दैट दैट पोजीशन, राइट? सो इफ दैट इज द लार्जर व्यू, देन देयर इज नो रीजन टू पैनिक एंड स्टार्ट एग्जिटिंग जस्ट बिकॉज इट्स गॉन अप 2x और 3x, राइट? हाउएवर इफ द मैंडेट इज कि एक साल का ही व्यू लेना है, और एक साल में अगर यू नो स्टॉक था 100 रुपीज और वो यू नो इट्स इट्स द टारगेट वाज 125 फेयर प्राइस एज वी कॉल इट, एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ 125 इट इज नाउ एट 135, वेल ओवर द फेयर प्राइस, यू कैन बाय ऑल मींस आइदर एग्जिट और ट्रिम डाउन योर पोजीशन. बट द वे वी लुक एट इट इज वी टिपिकली अवॉइड अवॉइड एग्जिटिंग टोटली एज लॉन्ग एज इट्स अ फंडामेंटली गुड स्टॉक टू होल्ड फॉर द नेक्स्ट कपल ऑफ इयर्स. All we do is we just trim down that position so that it is aligned to the sectoral weightages that we have assigned. And obviously there is a cap for every stock. ऐसा नहीं है कि stock 10% of portfolio के ऊपर चला गया है, let's say 15% चला गया, and we still are having it like that only. So that's how we would approach this.
So Jaspreet, the next question which we have been expecting is, you know, Murugan has asked this question. What about the recent guidelines released by the SEBI on the multi-cap? What would be effect on the large cap, small cap, and the mid-cap stocks?
Yeah, so a very good question, Mr. Murugan. Thanks for that. So this is a let's say a 10 lakh crore mutual fund market. Multi-cap is 1,40,000 crore. उसमें से you know जो ये ऊपर नीचे शफल होना है, that involves अगर होगा तो, राइट? आई विल टेल यू व्हाई व्हाई आई एम पुटिंग द वर्ड अगर. 42,000 करोड़ मोटा मोटा वेरी बॉल पार्क 42,000 करोड़ हैज टू बी मूव्ड फ्रॉम वन बकेट टू अनदर. उसके अंदर 28,000 करोड़ 28,000 करोड़ विल हैज टू मूव टू स्मॉल कैप एंड अबाउट 40,000 करोड़ टू मिड कैप. इसका इम्पैक्ट देयर इज अ यू नो इम्पैक्ट कॉस्ट जिसे बोलते हैं, आपने एंटर किया और एग्जिट किया, राइट? वो स्मॉल कैप्स में बहुत ज्यादा रहेगा, मिड कैप्स में थोड़ा कम रहेगा, लार्ज कैप्स में तो हार्डली फर्क रहेगा, बिकॉज स्मॉल लार्ज कैप्स इज लाइक मोर देन 8-9 लाख का पूल है. उसमें से आप 40,000 करोड़ का अगर बिक्री भी होती है, सेलिंग भी होती है, इट डजंट सेल टू मूव द नीडल टू मच. व्हाट सी व्हाट विल म्यूचुअल फंड्स डू टिपिकली इज एज पर द इंफॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल टिल टुडे, या वो मर्ज करेंगे अपनी स्कीम्स विद एनी अदर स्कीम विच इज विच हैज द सिमिलर मैंडेट, या फिर एक नया कैटेगरी खोलेंगे, मोस्ट लाइकली अ फ्लेक्सिबल कैटेगरी, उसमें शायद इसको पुश करेंगे, जिन जिनको करने की जरूरत है. सबको करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बट लेट्स से 80% ऑफ द मार्केट को करने की जरूरत है, तो इन दोनों में से एक जरूर करेंगे वो, राइट? एंड थोड़ा बहुत जो रह जाएगा वो शायद जो लोग हैं वो अपना पोर्टफोलियो ऊपर नीचे कर लेंगे बेसिस बेसिस you know, and they, so that they come closer to that mandate of 25%. But the message is clear that the 25% and all of that, whatever SEBI is prescribing, the message is clear. And I think overall directionally also our view is that mid and small caps should do rather well versus large caps going in the near term, which is near by near term. हमारा near term 2-4 महीने का नहीं होता, but it's let's say the next 1 year. Our sense is that mid and small caps should do better than large caps, and that is how we are also aligning our portfolios, be it moderate risk or high risk. Moderate risk में हम थोड़ा सा mid and small cap का हमने exposure बढ़ा दिया है, high risk में हमने mid and small cap का exposure और ज़्यादा बढ़ा दिया है. So let's say हमारा moderate risk में mid and small caps का exposure बढ़ने के बाद भी 40% है mid and small caps, and high risk portfolio में mid and small caps का exposure 60% है. बढ़ने के बाद, राइट? ये थोड़ा सा कम था, काफी कम था इससे एक महीना पहले और इस इवेंट के पहले. दैट्स हाउ वी हैव क्लियर मैसेज है, मिड एंड स्मॉल कैप शुड डू वेल रिलेटिव टू लार्ज कैप्स.
सो आवर वैल्यू इन्वेस्टर्स प्रणव एंड सुदर्शन, दे आर क्यूरियस टू नो, द गवर्नमेंट हैज इंपोज्ड बैन ऑन अनदर 110 चाइनीज एप्स रिसेंटली. So, what would be the impact of the disturbance, or the, I would say the tension which is brewing between our country and China? Do you think there can be a substantial market correction in the future if the situation worsens from here on?
See, it doesn't look like heading that way because China has to battle a bigger war with US than with India. I'm saying it's more on Twitter and verbal volleys that each of them throw at each other. But India specific, इतना हमारा बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ specific sectors में हमारा dependence ज़रूर है China से, which is let's say electronics, let's say pharma, let's say APIs and chemicals. वहां जरूर है, बट इट डजंट सीम टू बी हेडिंग इन अ डायरेक्शन कि कल को सी एप्स को बैन करने का आपके पास एक जेन्युइन रीजन है और आपने वो यूज करके आपको किया है, गवर्नमेंट ने किया है, इट सीम्स लेजिटिमेट एंड देयर इज नोबडी कैन कंटेस्ट इट. एक डिबेट बियॉन्ड अ पॉइंट आप इसमें कर नहीं सकते बिकॉज जहां सिक्योरिटी का मामला है, नेशनल सिक्योरिटी, एवरी गवर्नमेंट हैज एन इक्वल हैज अ राइट टू डू व्हाटएवर इट कैन टू इंश्योर कि वो उसमें कोई भी कुछ भी जरा किस्म का भी रिस्क अटैच ना हो. हाउएवर अगर ये ट्रेड सैंक्शंस होते देन बात कुछ और होती. अगर इंडिया ने इंपोर्ट ड्यूटी लगा दी होती फ्रॉम चाइनीज लेट्स से एलईडी पैनल्स और चाइनीज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स और चाइनीज फार्मा, जो अभी सिलेक्टिवली लगाई है, बहुत ज्यादा लगा, अगर बहुत ज्यादा अगर उस डायरेक्शन में अगर आप करने जाओगे देन ऑब्वियसली थोड़ा बैकलैश आएगा, दैट मे हैव अ लार्जर रिपरकशन. बट आई थिंक दे आर बोथ इंडिया चाइना नो ईच अदर स्ट्रेंथ्स एंड वीकनेसेस एंड दे आर मैच्योर इकोनॉमीज. दोनों ही एक दूसरे की हानि या वो दोनों का कुछ भी ऐसा नहीं करेंगे जिससे दोनों का ग्रोथ इंपैक्ट होगा. बोथ आर ग्रोथ इकोनॉमीज, दे आर नंबर टू नंबर वन ग्रोथ इकोनॉमी इन द वर्ल्ड. दोनों कुछ ऐसा नहीं करना करेगी जो जिससे उनकी ग्रोथ इतना इंपैक्ट होगी जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ सम डिसीजन दैट दे हैव टेकन. दैट मच इट लुक्स सर्टेन एज ऑफ नाउ.
Jaspreet, one of our value investor, he has asked this question. Purinjay Kumar, Mr. Purinjay Kumar has asked this question. Mutual funds, what is better when investing in the stock market? Mutual funds or direct equities? I know this has been a much debated topic all the time, but what do you recommend for a consistent growth in the stock market?
Okay, so the way I have this habit of giving examples while answering such question. So it's like, see, both have an equal role. Investment in gold, investment in property, investment in bank FDs, investment in mutual funds, everything is important, right? It's important is to understand aapka wealth manager ya aap khud aapko kya lagta hai, where is that allocation, right? We are strong proponents of the fact that equity will give you those multiplier returns which are not available in those asset classes, right? That is what we believe. And as long as age is on your side, as long as you have those capital which you can set aside for a long period of time, to start with, you should have, let's say, 10-20% of your investable surplus towards equity. Direct equity is what I mean. And gradually, as in over a period of time, quarter after quarter, year after year, जैसे जैसे आपको confidence मिलेगा, आप उसको बढ़ा सकते हैं, right? It's like me watching or us watching a match, let's say a cricket match from sitting on the stands, और आप match देख रहे हैं और एक और let's say आप एक level है where जहाँ पे आप घर पे बैठ के टीवी पे देख रहे हैं, दूसरा है आप ऑब्वियसली स्टैंड्स में बैठ के देख रहे हैं, राइट? एंड तीसरा ऑब्वियसली इज द अल्टीमेट वेयर यू प्लेइंग दैट क्रिकेट मैच राइट इन द फील्ड. यू आर अ प्लेयर हुज प्लेइंग दैट क्रिकेट मैच, राइट? सो द मोमेंट यू गेट इनटू दैट जोन वेयर यू प्लेइंग दैट क्रिकेट मैच योरसेल्फ, दैट्स द अल्टीमेट. दैट्स व्हाट विल गिव यू द बेस्ट 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 किक बिकॉज यू आर मेकिंग मनी बाय टेकिंग इन्फॉर्म्ड डिसीजंस बाय through legitimate means, right? By taking long-term approach and following the fundamentals and not having that short-term view. I mean, that's a different space altogether. We are not very good at that and we don't subscribe to that view. So this is how I would aspire to come to the stadium to have that get that experience, and that's a different experience. I'm sure आप agree करेंगे उससे कि घर बैठ के देखना और stadium बैठ के देखना कितना फर्क है. एक बार आपको वो मिल गया, then obviously the aspiration is कि आप जाके field में, as long as obviously age is on your side, आप pitch में उतर के हम direct क्यों ना खेलें, right? कब तक हम वहाँ दूर से बैठ के हम देखते रहेंगे, right? which is what you end up doing agar aap, you know, you put your majority of the money on through mutual fund because wahan pe fund managers zyada call lete hain aur aap so depends aapke paas jitna you can start with small as I said 10 to 20% of your surplus capital dheere dheere over a period of time aap usko 30-40% easily kar sakte hain maybe I mean there are clients who have 70-80% of surplus investable surplus wo khud directly manage karte hain through such in taking informed decisions through taking the help or support of advisors like us or other participants in the industry.
Thanks, Jaspreet, for answering that question. We have one more question. Now, everybody wants to know which are going to be the new age sectors, or I would say stocks. Considering that a lot has changed since the COVID-19 crisis, which are the top sectors that are going to be there in your watch list?
So yeah, we discussed that briefly in our one of our previous slide. That is obviously the spaces of chemical, pharma. Yeah, this is it. If you can see that chemical, pharma, agrochem is our you can call it new age or sectors where we have increased our weightages of late. As I said, in moderate risk we are 20% or below. In high risk portfolios we are recommending 25% or more. This is closely followed by IT media, right? We are as much as 10% in high risk. And moderate risk, we are 8% or below, and followed by consumer discretionary. Consumer discretionary is a very big space, right? Auto bhi aayega, retail, footwear, paints. There are many many categories. Jo isme electronics, you know, white goods, brown goods. Isme kya hai? Isme aap कोई भी एक्सपेंडिचर जो 500 रुपए से लेके 5000 तक 10000 15000 20000 का जो भी खर्चा होता है राइट इवन 50000 अप टू अ पॉइंट बिकॉज आजकल यू नो यू लुक एट द मोबाइल फोन्स 50000 प्लस पे भी जा रहे हैं राइट सो आई मीन वेयर ऑब्वियसली पीपल एंड अप बाइंग 50000 प्लस मोबाइल फोन्स तो दिस इज द एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग व्हिच इज 500 टू 550000 यू नो टिकट साइज दैट बिकम्स द सेमी डिस्क्रिशनरी अल्ट्रा डिस्क्रिशनरी ऑब्वियसली इज द is a, let's say a real estate or a luxury real estate or high end vacation or buying a movie ticket for a high end multiplex in the best seat in the best theater best audience best seat and or buying the best car right car ke bhi alag alag categories hain Honda sells 7 lakh car they sell 15 lakh car they also sell a 40 lakh car right these are mostly sedans or SUVs right So it depends, right? So that's broadly how I would sum it up.
I've got a very interesting question from Sudarshan. He wants to know, considering the agricultural stocks have emerged as a hero, what is your view on the future of agri stocks in India, considering the recent farming reforms?
Okay, yeah, that's a relevant point. It's heading the right way. There are good reforms happening. And also India is blessed with third year of consecutive good monsoons and back to back good rabi and kharif sowing and harvest. I think this story is there for some more time. I'm saying time again. Our earlier time ka matlab hai, couple of quarters, couple of years. We don't look at months or days. This is a good space to be in. But we would obviously have a reasonable percentage allocated to this space as well for a prolonged period of time. It's just not a couple of quarters view. We would have it for a couple of years.
Okay, so the last question, Jaspreet, which I have for today over here is basically, what is your view considering the performance in the banking and the NBFC sector? What according to you, when the recovery, robust recovery will happen, and do you see any threats to this sector in the coming future?
Okay, yeah, any discussion can't end without discussing the banking and the BFSI, as we call it, banking and financial services industry. No doubt and no denying the fact ki sector mein bahut upar niche ho raha hai, right? Bahut volatility hai and it will continue for at least two more quarters, right? But that's about it, right? Two quarter ka aur hame thoda isko dekhna hai, samajhna hai, and that's the testing time. Ek testing time chhe do quarters ho gaye, and maybe another two more quarters. Within that, what are we? How are we positioning ourselves, right? two things. One is obviously hum thoda weightage kam rakh rahe hain. We have it between 15 and 20%, right? Aggressive mein 20% and moderate risk mein 15%. Within that, the idea is to have relatively higher exposure. Relative means compared to earlier times, higher exposure to non-lending categories, which is insurance, life in general, which is AMCs, which is broking, right? Because they are relatively less impacted in many cases, like broking, wo to growth mein hai, right? There is a phase of, or there is a term Robin Hood trading, which is happening. And obviously, uski wajah se kafi broking companies acha kar rahi hai, right? So that is the space in which we are. If we had 10% exposure earlier, I'm saying if I take BFSI as a basket of 100 rupees, if earlier we had, let's say a 60, 30, 10 kind of a mix, which is 60 banks and 30 NBFCs and 10 of non-lending. Today, I would probably have a 50 a bank and maybe a 25, 20 NBFC and maybe 30 as the non-lending piece. So clear, more number two is non-lending, which is AMC, insurance and broking, followed by NBFCs at the end. Why NBFC is very simple. Unka cost of capital kafi badh gaya hai, aur samne wo jo growth unko chahiye wo utni nahi mil rahi hai, na wo jitna unhone socha tha karenge wo is samay. Jyada growth hai bhi nahi system mein, and jo hai, that is largely getting taken away by the larger players or even some cases by the banks themselves. Kyunki cost of funding bahut badh gayi aur aage wo jis rates pe aage karenge wo, that becomes very, very not so attractive for some of the sectors. So our sense is non-lending will be number one, followed by banking, followed by NBFC in that overall BFSI basket. Point number one. Point number two is it's a matter of two more quarters of pain before, I'm saying max, right? It could be just one more quarter, right? It could be just in November ke baad hi we are getting those signs and offshoot as economy picks up, as we start going out, everything is normalized, closer to getting normalized. Our sense is that phase should be there by November end. Next 2 months mein, as an economy comes back on its feet, 90% or more, all sections of the economy, this sector will start going up. Ek mahine mein to upar nahi jayega, dheere 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 dheere, obviously till March it will keep on happening like that.
Jaspreet, on the request, I'll take one more question, and this is going to be the last question. Is what are the key parameters to identify multi-bagger stocks? The most important question, I'm sure many people would be having this question. If you can throw more light on how to identify multi-bagger stocks.
Sure. So let's look at, understand what is a multi-bagger, right? Multi-baggers are where you're getting 3x, 4x, 5x, okay? 5x in let's say 5 years, 5x in 6 years, 7 years, 8 years, whatever, right? That's obviously the aspiration. That's what we call multi-bagger, right? Agar 5x hai, means karna hai, right? If that's the ambition, or that's the goal, that's your objective, over whatever period of time that one aspires to be, it means roughly 35-40%, let's say 37% of compounding year after year for the next 5 years, right? Now, the idea is a large portion of this 37% should be backed by earnings growth, should be, right? And by large, I mean 60%, you know, anywhere between 60 to 70%. So let's say, taking this example, 37% may say, agar earnings growth 25% ki hai, 25% hai, balance 12%, believe me, will come from re-rating. And you will get that 30%, 37% compounding, right? So let's say a stock hai, which is 100 rupee of value today. Theek hai? Aaj uska EPS 100 rupee hai. Theek hai? Aaj uska price, aaj uska P multiple jo usko mil raha hai, wo 10 rupee hai. To price ho gaya uska CMP, uska 1000 rupee. Agle saal, agar usme, if it delivers 25% growth, so what's the next EPS? Next is EPS, 125 rupees, 125 rupee. Theek hai? P अगर उसका 10 है और P अगर मुझे 12% की मैं अगर वो लेता हूँ, 12% is nothing but 11.2, right? Now you multiply 11.2 with 125 rupees EPS, right? You will get a number which is 137. ठीक है, तो मुझे पहला मेरा पहले साल का 137 रुपीज मिल गया, मतलब 37% मेरे को रिटर्न मिल गया उसमें। अगले साल फिर वही वही होना है, विच इज द ईयर टू, राइट, 25% और अर्निंग्स ग्रोथ ऑन अ बेस ऑफ 125, ठीक है, और जो 12% का पी री रेटिंग है, जो 11 का है वो 12.5 हो जाए द ईयर आफ्टर, एंड दिस कीप्स ऑन हैपनिंग फॉर फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स ईयर आफ्टर, ठीक है। अभी इतना इतना एक्सेल बेस्ड या वैसे होता नहीं है, मार्केट इज नॉट एज स्मूथ एज आई एम ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू, बट इट इज ऑब्वियसली यू नो इट देर आर ईयर्स व्हेन द अर्निंग्स ग्रोथ इज 1 year when the earnings growth is 450%, then 1 year is 30%, 1 year is 10%, and there's another year which is 80%, right? So that obviously has its which is what we call the business momentum, right? The jo area hum usko bolte. And if you have that, the re-rating also will happen not like that, 12% year after year. Wo re-rating seedha ek hi bar wo 20-25% ho jayegi. Next year it will happen another 20-25%, right? Straight away in 2 years, less than 2 years, you'll have a re-rating of 50%, right? So, and very, very high chance ki wo 2 saal mein hi wo 3x ho gaya, rather than going up 1x, 1x, 1x each year for the next 5 years. So but the broad directionally, you should have a very, very high visibility on earnings, very high conviction that this is a minimum 20%. Right, maybe a 30% and maybe a 40% earnings compounder for the next couple of years. अगर वो 20 से 40% की earnings growth compounding अगर हम आपको दिखती है, right, you should by all means put that in your funnel, in your stock list from which you can choose. Let's say आपने funnel बना के you picked about 30 stocks where you think earnings can grow 30% or more. After that you can pick. This is how we do. Then we pick about let's say the best 10 out of those 20 and best 10 out of those 30, and then we put that in our business momentum bucket, which is where we put about 50 up to 50% of our model portfolio, right? हम सारा ही उसमें क्यों नहीं डाल देते हैं? Obviously you need to have a risk reward. There is a risk mitigation that needs to be done. Suppose it's not a good market. Suppose it's an event like this which has hit the market, and suppose the earnings doesn't pan out the way we thought it would, right? So आपके portfolio को stability भी चाहिए, right? So that it doesn't go below the base value or the cost price. Therefore, you need to have some of those steady compounders, which are those consistent compounders जो जिसे बोलते हैं. Which are as typically from the likes of large cap IT, large cap FMCG, large cap paints, right, large cap pharma to some extent, and some of the economy facing names. So uska bhi let's say 40-50% contribution hona zaruri hai. That's how we position our portfolio.
Thanks, Jaspreet, for patiently answering all the questions. We really appreciate the timeless inputs shared by you today. Once again, if you have any queries, feel free to drop your queries on our email ID, createwealth@theraterearchandranking.com. We'll look forward to all of you in the next webinar. Till then, happy investing, happy wealth creation. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.